Hi, my name is Abel. I'm a cloud developer advocate specializing in DevOps. Visual Studio Team Services is the ultimate DevOps solution into Azure. And now, with the general availability of Azure DevOps Projects, we make it dirt simple to go from nothing at all to a full end-to-end DevOps project in a variety of languages. And what's in this DevOps project? You get a team project in VSTS, code for the sample project in the language that you picked in the repo, a CI/CD pipeline that will take your sample code, build it, and deploys it all the way up into the infrastructure it provisions for you up in Azure. And you get all of this with just a couple of clicks. Now, we all know that containers, they're the hottest thing in our industry right now. And DevOps projects did not forget about containers. Let's go see how easy it is to go from nothing and create a container DevOps project for a .NET Core application. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a brand new Azure DevOps project. So we're going to go to create a resource, go to DevOps project, and from here, we get a screen that's going to ask us what language we want to use. So we're going to go ahead and choose .NET, and we're going to choose ASP.NET Core, click on Next, and now it's going to ask us what infrastructure up in Azure do we want to deploy to. Since we want to do a container, let's go ahead and choose Web App for Containers, click on Next, and now it's going to ask us what instance of Visual Studio Team Services do you want to use. We can use a brand new one or use an existing one. I'm going to go ahead and choose my demo account. So here's my demo account. And from here, I have to give this a name. So we'll call this Abel Core Container. And we'll go ahead and choose the region. And let's deploy this in the West because I am on the West Coast, of course. And we'll click on Done, and bam. That is literally all we need to do. We are totally done now. We can just kick back, relax, and let Azure do its thing. So now it's going to build out for us this DevOps project, where it will create for us a team project in VSTS. It will put a sample code into the repo in VSTS, and then it will build us a CI/CD pipeline that's going to take this app, build it, turn it into a container, and then deploy that container all the way out into Azure. And when it's all done doing that, you end up with your portal looking something like this. Where on the left-hand side, you're going to see everything that's related to your CI/CD pipeline. And on the right-hand side, you're going to see all the resources that it deployed into Azure. Now, all of these links are deep links into all the resources. So if I click on this deep link into the code, it will take us into VSTS, where in VSTS, it'll be the code repository. So as you can see, this is just a sample .NET Core application. Now the build that it creates is going to create a build for you that makes sense for the technology that you picked. So let's go ahead and jump into the build. And from here, we'll go ahead and edit this build so you can see exactly what we're doing. Now, the build that we create, since we chose a .NET Core app that turns into a container, let's wait for this to come up, you'll see that we're going to go ahead and take this, we're going to build a container, and then we're going to push this image to Azure Container Registry. Now, once it's done, we will go ahead and release this, and we'll release this container using an app service tasks. Now, there's nothing more for you to configure. There's nothing more for you to do. Everything just works. However, if you wanted to customize this, you still absolutely can. If you wanted to customize the code, this is just a Git repo. So you can just come in here, clone this repo onto your hard drive, delete all the files and put your code in here, push it back up into VSTS, and then everything will flow all the way out into app service. If for whatever reason you wanted to tweak that build, absolutely no problem. This is VSTS. The build is just a task runner. So I can come in here, and the way that you customize builds in VSTS is that you add and remove tasks. Now, we can go ahead and add tasks, and as you can see, out of the box, there are hundreds of tasks that you can pick from. And if what you want to do happens to not exist out of the box, that's not a problem. You can jump into the marketplace. Now, in the marketplace, our partners have created over 500 build and release tasks that you can just download and start using. And if what you want to do doesn't exist out of the box and doesn't exist in the marketplace, that's not a problem either, because you can just jump in and create your own custom tasks. Custom tasks, these are nothing more than PowerShell or Node.js, so it's super easy to create your own custom tasks that can do whatever you need it to do. And I always say, if you can do something from the command line, you absolutely can create a custom task that VSTS will go and execute. Azure DevOps Projects makes creating your end-to-end DevOps pipelines into Azure incredibly simple. With a couple of clicks, everything just starts working. And yet, you still have full control over your CI/CD pipelines to customize and configure it to do whatever you need. And with the GA of Azure DevOps Projects, we now support containers into Azure as well.